vulgar about this movement, but all I'm doing is trying to stabilize the chair. Welcome to the show. I haven't sat like this in a really long time. I feel like I could either fly or just sit still and do the show. So anyway, I've been sitting on the same chair for 2 years. I've been doing this show for 2 years and I've never, ever, ever, ever sat on another chair besides this one. It's tearing away. But my bosses don't think that I should get a new chair. If this is happening to a chair and I don't think they need to change it. So what exactly is going to happen to my paycheck? Anyway, hopefully I can grab one at Gummy and Meepa. They've got these really cute ones. Not that my butt can fit there, but if your butt can fit there, especially if you're a child, go get one of those ones. And then they have this. If you're potty training and it's becoming really hard, Gummy and Meepa have an alternative, a potty chair. One of the two. It will make it so easy for you. I mean, the baby will sit, but then do their poo at the same time, yeah. So go to Gummy and Meepa. And besides that potty chair potty, they've got also very many other things. I was talking about chairs before I got into the potty business. Yes, they've got really nice chairs for your kids. You know, the nice plastic chairs, the adorable ones, the ones that were not there when we were growing up. Yes, they are there now. So don't deny your child a chance to sit on a cute plastic, very bright colored chair because you did not sit on one. Things change. Go to Gummy and Meepa today. Grab them a chair, but also grab them very many other things. There's shoes, there's clothes, there's bags, there's dolls, there's beds. There's everything you're going to need for your child. Gummy and Meepa located at Forest Mall Shop number 64, level 2. Go grab something today. And Rexona. You know, no, you don't know, obviously. Whatever it is that you're looking for, I know if you're pregnant, you're away, you're going as far from strong scents as you can, and Rexona is watching it because the scent is subtle, but it will also remind you that you're wearing something in your underarms because it smells really good. Grab Rexona today, and you will know exactly what I mean. The word on the street is that Fina Masanyalaze is frantic, and the reason she is, but has she just also just woken up and realized that there's a video circulating of a girl whose flower is being touched, who exactly looks like her? Did she just realize? Because I saw this video like last week. Yeah, so Fina has just realized that there's a video out there and she is, like I said, frantic. Are you just looking for a reason to be in the news, Fina Masanyalaze? Because if that is, there's so many other things to do. Like, can you show us your bum? Huh? That will guarantee you some tabloid time. Believe me, you won't need to do much. Just show the people your bum. I'm just saying that if you've sold yourself to the devil, you might as well fly to hell first class. Yeah? Don't just go around telling us how that girl in the video is not me or that girl in the video. We can all tell that it's not you. And even the men who have slept, you can also tell that that is not your flower. You think men can't tell them apart? They can. Just by looking at them, they can tell that you, I asked you to take a picture of your nyam nyam and all you did was ask your more vulgar friend to send me her picture. They can tell that that's not you. Unless there's a picture or there's a video that you're trying to warn us about. You're telling us that that's not me. Na yeye akange kaja. Then please go ahead and tell us. Otherwise, if you're just going to go ahead and tell us, no, that's not me in the picture, don't bore us. We have more important things to also listen to. For example, can you tell us what happened between Cindy and Ken Muyisa? That would be a more interesting story than telling us how the girl in the picture who is being stroked is not you, obviously. So anyway, can you just call me up and tell me what really happened between your baby daddy and what do I call Cindy today? Anyway, it's a Thursday. Let's just chill and call her Cindy. You know, when Busy Signal was in the country the last time he was here, my God, Sheba was lining up at Busy Signal's entrance and a bunch of other video vixens and other girls who can't keep their legs together. That's where we got the phrase open leg syndrome. Every victim of that was lining up on Busy Signal's door looking for like some me time with Mr. Signal. Like looking for... I was going to say something really vulgar, but again, let's just stick to, you know, the fact that we have a daytime situation going on. Anyway, so, and I won't be really surprised if, you know, Busy hit that and he just doesn't want to hit that again. But Nayanda is also in town. I don't know if she's still here or left. Nayanda watched Mumuasa. Like, King Lawrence, why don't you just marry this girl and get her a house somewhere? Where with your borrowed money, maybe because you would want to please her, put her in Muyenga or something like that. Just have kids with her and let her not Because spare her the time, eh? And the money that she spends on and off the bus, no, plane. Every time she has to come to this country, she spends money. And it's not like she can't stay here. She can. She just needs reason to stay here. And the collabos that are lined up, I'm told Leila Kayondo has one with her. Okay, let's first of all deal with Kayondo. Why is Leila still investing money in music? And I understand the need to be relevant. Because for girls like Leila Kayondo, she needs the music to keep her relevant. Yeah, there's nothing really special about Leila. She's dumb, she's not beautiful, there's nothing to write home about. So for her, in her myopic head, the only reason why she's doing music is because that's what keeps her in the news, keeps her relevant. It has the artist tag or musician tag onto her name, musician or artist Leila Kayondo, Uganda's female artist Leila Kayondo. It doesn't really have anything to do with the fact that she actually lives up to that title. No! For her, she threw caution to the wind. The day she said she did this to her legs for Mbuga is the very day she said, Owange, this is no longer about music. And also, I think the fact that Mbuga is investing money in her because, again, for music, and I hate air quotes, but I'm using them right now, but for music's sake, and for him, the fact that every time he hangs out with her, he gets his tabloid time. So it's sort of, but then I don't even know what I'm saying. Why are we even wasting time on Leila? Like, why? But anyway, also because the industry forgave her. At least that's what my producer said. But for people like Leila Kayondo, the industry forgave her. Like, it's okay for her to be a mediocre. Also because, you know, like the saying that everybody would think they're sharp or they're smart if there were no foolish people or stupid people. Every musician, when they rate themselves compared to Kayondo, they're like, oh, Owange Kastai can sing better than Leila Kayondo. And those musicians, that's where they get their comfort from. So for people like Leila, she can stay in the industry, but I don't understand why she continues to invest money in these videos. Now, I know she poured bonkers money in Nayanda to get that collabo. Nayanda is also like a road now. Like, everybody can drive along that road, get a collabo. Like, but when you think about people like Helen Lukoma, Helen, for the love of God, go to church. You know, there is nobody in a church, no one says you can't sing because you're singing for Jesus. Also, he's the one who gave you no voice. So it's not like you're going to be, anybody's going to say anything wrong about it, because, well, everybody praises God, whether they can sing or not sing. Praises are music to God's ears. So regardless of whether you have musical vocals or not, it will sound okay. Also, Balokole don't point fingers at anybody. They just applaud you. Even with your lack of talent, they'll be like, you're God's child after all. You know what? I already feel drained just talking about people who don't matter. Like, if I feel drained just discussing people who don't matter, how about the men who sleep with them? Huh? Anyway, speaking of men sleeping with people, maybe not. Just call me up if you can, you know, just please call me up. And these days it's been made very easy. You can just use voice binders. Just call me up in case you need some time on this show. I know that there are so many people who want to speak out on certain things. What's his name? Governor Pro? Governor Pro and your darling. You know, the funny thing is that nobody ever mentions this woman's name. They just call her the old woman. Doesn't she have a name? You can come and tell us her name and speak out on this show. Governor Pro. In fact, I've never been interested. Is that his name? Governor S. You see? I've never been really interested in anybody like I'm interested in you, and not what you think now. Just because I want to hear your side of the story. I've heard so much, but I want her. I also want her to talk about you. What's her name, first of all? Come to the show, call me up. I don't know if I can find you on Facebook, but I will obviously get in touch with you, leave you with my number. Like I said, you can call me on voice bundles. 15 minutes of calls for just 1,000 shillings on MTN, just in case the chick doesn't give you that much money for airtime. I'm out of here. Please go buy Gummy and Mipa today and buy something for Chad and so use Brexona. I'm even...